Alright, so this one is a little bit more sciencey. I'm going to talk about conditioning of the brain. Now, specifically with landscape conditioning, like let's say you are born in the desert, you live there your whole life, you know, it's accustomed to, it's something that is not a shock for somebody who's lived in a mountain forested area their whole life. So when something is a custom, you know, you're accustomed to that, that's what your regular is, you know, your regular landscape scenario. Okay. So when people acclimate and these events happen and they've been there and then the things are cut and they're gone and then they've been there a while more, they start acclimating to desertified regions. And they acclimate and think that it's normal. They acclimate and think that it's absolutely normal to have gross, disgusting, large fields. They acclimate and they think it's normal that there are not a lot of birds. They think it's normal that there is not a lot of wildlife. They think it's normal that there are very few trees, aside from ones that you may buy at a garden store. So those types of acclimations, when you've been conditioned one way, and then the brain starts to twist on you, that is the biggest cheat of all. To be a person who is a grown up in the forest and then become acclimated to the nothing, to the barren. That is the biggest cheat of all. If the person does not recognize it when it's happening, they have lost their lost something in their brain. Yeah, so when the brain is going through, okay, you have this is right and this is wrong, and yet the wrong is winning again and again and again with this landscape destruction policy that appears to be a molecule, appears to be something that's absolutely inside people's brains. That is an evil, I will say an evil, yes, because it's a destroyer. If it's an evil that's in their brain that they're intent on keeping, is it really an evil one person to one person, or is it a group evil? You have to look at it that way also. Is that evil created? Is it created by the veracity of others in their inclusion? Yes, I agree with you. Yes, I agree with you. Oh, I'm so lonely. I have to have somebody agree with me. Is it a societal molecule? Is it one that demands on society itself to grow like a cancer? And yes, absolutely. Is it one that is sociable, that demands sociability for its survival? Now that is, because we're trying to identify the evil molecule, is it one that is an isolated one? Meaning, the isolated character that just wants to destroy an entire forest all by himself? I find that unusual. I believe it is a societal molecule. I believe it's one that is bolstered up and grows further by agreement, by actually hearing agreement with others. So it means it's a follower molecule in a way. We look at it that way. It's a follower, that each one of these people causing these heinous crimes to the planet are followers. They're this society group molecule of followers. All right. So, great, one would say. But now, how did it begin? Who started it? Who was the beginner that has the minions of that pushes that out? That has the marchers of the evil? Who is the instigator? All right, so it helps. So when you're talking to somebody that is a complete, absolute idiot and a world destroyer type, we have to see them as they are simply, for the most part, followers. They are just followers. And they are groupies. And it's their fan club. They are members of their fan club. All right, so as we look at them that way, it doesn't help dismantle them right now, but maybe how do you dismantle the group? Well, I go back to the Colosseum again. How do you dismantle that? Back to the Roman Colosseums. That ordinate group, that group that is just stuck to itself as a cancer. How do you dismantle that group? Because that's what these people are. That's what these far left, no, I'm not far left. See, I'm completely out. I'm sorry. Far right, yeah. Tried to twist my molecule. Far right, that's the Republican side, right? R for Republican. What else do you call them? Yeah, them. Industrialists, yeah. So their molecule. I look at them as a stuck cancer. I visited once with, it was about a year before my mom died. I visited with a doctor who was she worked for the US government for a time. And she talked about cancer and she viewed my mom's blood under my magnifier and all. And with a microscope, and it's all about the coagulation effect, you know, that stick, you know. And when something is evil, like a cancer, it has an overstick. It gets twisted, and yet it still has an overstick with its interrupt, you know, so it's going through the bloodstream. And it morphs into something ugly, and then sticks to another one like it, another friend, you know. So it becomes like a friend that is just, yes, another evil ugly, yes, another evil ugly. So that's what's going on in the bloodstream. So if we look at these events, and people who are dead set to destroy planet Earth, we look at them as that same similar group inside our bloodstream, that evil ugly, that group of yeah, we look weird underneath microscopes, don't we, all those little tiny shapes, yeah, but I imagine, look at them as a particular shape that sticks to other shapes just like it. Maybe that'll help us solve the problem. Yeah, I know I have these videos longer. I can go, you know, 3 hours if I want, but maybe that'll help us solve the problem.